Before we start, the most important beginner's tip in Dota is that you can click on the shop menu and the browse all guides button here to find user-made guides that tell you what items to buy and highlight what spells you should learn. The structure of a Dota game is much like League. Waves of minions known as creeps fight each other and give you gold and XP for killing them. Your goal is to destroy towers and barracks known as inhibitors in League, which make the creeps stronger, and eventually destroy the ancient here to win the game. Both teams have 5 heroes assigned into 5 different roles of rough equivalents in League. The carry's job is to farm XP and items and do the most damage in the late game. Mid laners face each other one-on-one, gaining items and using them to fight early. Instead of top laners, Dota has off laners. Since the map is asymmetrical, off laners face the other team's support and carry, not the other team's off laner. Like top laners, they're hard to kill and good at starting fights. Instead of a jungler, Dota teams have 2 supports. Usually, one support roams between lanes providing ganks like junglers, while the other is focused on placing wards and helping the team. Your general strategy is to have one support in each lane with the carry in the safe lane, but be ready to switch lanes if needed. Characters in Dota have stats such as mana and health, but they also have 3 new types of stats: strength, agility, and intelligence. These stats increase your other stats. Strength provides max health and health regen, agility provides attack speed and armor, and intelligence provides max mana and mana regen. Here's a list of what you get with 1 point in each stat. Each hero also has a primary stat highlighted in color here. This stat increases your attack damage in addition to its regular benefits. Dota has no mechanics like runes or summoner spells that are unlocked outside of the match itself. Everyone starts on equal ground. Instead, many items have active abilities that fulfill similar roles to summoner spells. The most important item in the whole game is right here, the Town Portal Scroll. This item lets you teleport back to base or to any friendly tower on the map. These cost only 100 gold and you get a free one every time you die, so use them frequently to defend lanes, rescue your allies who are being attacked, or just to return the lane faster. Teleporting is not interrupted by damage, only by stun and root effects, meaning you can escape some heroes of a teleport. Each player also has a special unit here called a courier. The courier is used to deliver items from the base to your hero without having to travel all the way back. Press the F2 key to control the courier manually. You can also use the spell keys when it is selected to give it commands. Press F3 to have it simply collect your items and bring them to you. Remember to press F1 to select your hero again when you're done. Couriers holding healing potions and other consumables move slower. In addition to items purchased from the shop, each jungle creep has a small chance of dropping neutral items, which are unique items that have their own inventory slot and can be shared between teammates. As the game goes on, higher tiers of neutral item will drop, getting stronger with each tier. Only 5 items from each tier can drop, so communicate with your team to figure out who should have which items. Other important features of the map include the 2 power rune spots at these locations. Every 2 minutes, a random power rune spawns here, giving a unique effect to the hero that takes it. You can mouse over runes in-game to see what they do, or just pause the video right here. These are the bounty rune spots. Every 3 minutes, a bounty rune spawns here that gives golden experience to you and your team. At the start of the game, one of these bounty runes spawns at each power rune and bounty rune spot. Be ready to have small fights over these runes, but don't die just to secure them. These are the outposts. Each outpost starts out controlled by one team, and after that team loses at least 1 tier 2 tower, the other team can steal the outpost. Outposts provide vision and experience to the whole team and can be teleported to at a slower speed than towers. This is Roshan's Pit. Roshan is a big boss monster that drops a one-time use item that causes the person carrying it to resurrect 5 seconds after death at the spot they died. Fight Roshan as a team whenever you cannot safely push into the enemy base. Some heroes can fight Roshan on their own, but it's not recommended for beginners. Finally, these buttons next to the minimap are global powers that share a cooldown across all team members. They are the Scan and the Glyph. The Scan tells you if enemy heroes are in a small targeted area on the map, turning red if they are and green if not. The Glyph makes your towers and creeps immune to damage for a few seconds. Use these at critical moments to get information before a fight or to buy your building some extra time. When a tier 1 tower is destroyed, the glyph refreshes. And that's it, good luck!